Hello friends, in the previous session we had started with a new data type, that is the tuples data type. In this session let's cover more about the tuples data type. So in this session let's see tuple packing, tuple unpacking, why addition of items is not possible in tuples, why updation of items is not possible in tuples, and why deletion of items is not possible in tuples. So what is tuple packing and what is tuple unpacking? Tuple packing means a tuple can be created without using parentheses. This is known as tuple packing. Suppose I'm having tuple 1 equal to 1, 3.14 and then Python. It has not been enclosed within the parentheses. Even then it is treated as a tuple. This is called as the tuple packing. And when we print tuple 1, it will print in the tuple format, that is with the parenthesis. So it can be created without using parenthesis. This is known as tuple packing. And what is tuple unpacking? We can get the individual items of the tuple and extract them in variables, individual variables. This is known as tuple unpacking. So let's see how it works. Suppose I'm having tuple 2 equal to 1, 3.14, Python, and there are three items in the tuple. So if I say if I give three variables, say a, b, c equal to tuple 2, then a will hold the value 1, b will hold the value 3.14, and c will hold the value Python. So it is, the items have been assigned to individual variables, that is a, b, c. So when we print A, 1 will be returned. When we print B, 3.14 will be returned. And when we print C, the word Python will be returned. Let's look into it practically. So if I say tuple 1 equal to 1, 3.14, Python. So I'm not enclosed it within the parenthesis. Now this is called tuple packing. And now if I say print tuple 1, the output will be in the tuple format. It's enclosed within the parenthesis. So this concept is called as tuple packing. Now let's see tuple unpacking. Suppose I'm having my tuple 2 equal to 1, 3.14, Python. So these are the items. Now I say give individual variables to hold each of the items. Since there are three items, I'll give three variables A, B, C equal to tuple 2. Now if I try to print A, and then print B, then print C. Now if I run the code, A will have the value 1, B will hold the value 3.14, and C will hold the value Python. So this is how the individual items can be extracted into individual variables. This is called as tuple unpacking. In tuple unpacking, we can see some miscellaneous examples. Suppose I have my colors tuple, which is holding red, blue, green, white, black, and gray. And now if I say, in this if I don't know how many items are there, so I specify a, b for the remaining items. I give it as star C. So when I print A will give out the value red, B will print the value blue, and C, when I print C, it will give the remaining items in the list format. So green, white, black, gray will be returned within the list. So it will print out the format in the list format. So this comes under tuple unpacking. If I say tuple 3 equal to, or I'll take colors equal to red, comma blue, comma yellow, and then black, and then white, and then gray. So if I say A comma B comma star C equal to colors, so A is having, will hold individual value, so it will have the value red, B will have the value blue, and star C will hold the remaining values, that is yellow, black, white and gray in the list format. So if we don't know how many items are there in the tuple, we can specify star and then the variable, so it will hold the remaining items. Now if I say print A, print B, and print, we have to specify only C, not star C. And now if I run my code, I get A equal to red, B equal to blue, and the remaining items have been represented in the list format. So this is how tuple unpacking works in Python. Now I have given A, B and star C. If I remove star C, if I remove star in C and give the star in B, then A will hold the value red, star C will hold the last value, that is gray, and the in-between values will be held by B. So now if I run my code, A will have the value red, C will have the last item, that is gray, and B will hold the in-between items in the list format. This is how tuple unpacking works in Python. And now let's move on to addition of elements. In list, we could add an item into the list with the append, insert and extend built-in function. This was possible because lists are mutable. We can add elements into the list at any point of time. But we cannot do the same in tuples. Addition of items is not possible in tuples as they are immutable. So we do not have these functionalities like append, insert and extend in tuples. Updation of elements in tuples. We could update elements in the list. Suppose we had a list. At any point of time, we could change the value of the item in the list by specifying LST1 of 1 index 1 equal to 10. So 0, 1 index is 1. At the first index I am having 2. So 2 gets changed to 10. So updation of items are possible in list because lists are mutable. We can change the value of the items at any point of time. The same we cannot achieve in tuples. They give out an error called item assignment is not possible in tuples when we try to update the value within the tuple. So let's see in both the scenarios, the list and the tuple. Suppose my LST1 is a list having 1, 2, 3 and then 4. Now if I say LST1 index 1 equal to 50. Now if I say print LST1, then instead of 2, I will have the value 50. So instead of 2, 50 has been replaced. So we can update the value of the item in list. Now let's make it as a tuple. TUP1, and we have to give it in parentheses for tuples. And now if I say TUP1 1 of 1 equal to 50, print TUP1. Now if I run the code, I get a type error. That is, tuple object does not support item assignment. We can't assign value, we can't change the value of the item in the tuple. Tuple does not support it because tuples are immutable. We cannot change the value of the item at any point of time once it has been created. So this is the difference between lists and tuples. Similarly, and one more miscellaneous example we can cover over here. Suppose in my tuple, I am having a list 20, 30, 40. Within the tuple, a list has been enclosed. And now if I want to change the individual item of the list, this is possible even though it is within a tuple. Because lists are mutable, so even though it is within the tuple, I can change the value of it. So 1 will be at 0th index, 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I want to change 4, then I have to specify 1 to 50. So in 4th item is the list. In that I want to change the index 1. Index 1 is holding the value 30. So it will get changed to 50. So now if I run the code, instead of 30, I have got the value 50. So we can change the value within the list even though it is enclosed within a tuple. So this is one of the miscellaneous examples. Moving on to deletion, if we have a list, we can delete individual items in the list and the items get deleted. The same, we can't do it in tuples because tuples are immutable and it gives the item deletion is not possible in tuples. Let's see it practically. Suppose I'm having LST1 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if I say del LST1 of 1. Now if I print LST1 and run the code, 2 has been deleted. The item at the first index, that is 2, has been deleted from the list. Let's check out the same with tuple. Comma 4, tuple 1 of 1, delete tuple 1 of 1. And now if I say print tuple 1, and run the code, it says tuple object does not support item deletion. So we cannot change the tuple once it has been created. We cannot update the tuple. We cannot add items into the tuple. We cannot delete the tuple. But if we have a list inside the tuple and if I say delete tuple 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 4 of 1. If I want to change the individual list item within the tuple, then it is possible. So 20 has been deleted from the list. Even though the list is within the tuple, we can delete the individual items in the list, but not the individual items within the tuple. And suppose I say delete tuple 1. So the tuple 1 has been deleted. Again, when I say print tuple 1, it says tuple 1 is not defined because the whole tuple has been deleted. We can delete the whole tuple at once, but we cannot delete individual items in the tuple. So this is deletion of items in tuples. And we also saw a miscellaneous example with a list enclosed in it, and we could delete the individual items in the list. So friends, hope so it is clear for you. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.